Hello, hello, namaste, peace and blessings. Thank you so much for joining me, Online Yoga School Virtual Studio. We are going to get started in our session here today. I ask that we find our bodies in a comfortable seated pose. Any easy seat that feels good for you, may you find your seat. I am sitting in a half lotus. As we are using our easy seat to help relax and wind down our mind and bodies here today. Ensuring that our spinal cords are nice and elongated, meaning we are not sunken. Having control of that body with our tummy tucked in at our navel and our shoulders are relaxed downward away from our ears. As we gaze our eyes downward, we'll close our eyes. Taking a nice deep breath in. Exhale through the mouth. Breathe in deeply. Exhale. Taking a moment to notice how the breath feels within the body as we relax in silent meditation before natural breaths. As we breathe our palms at heart center, coming into a seated prayer, maybe our thumbs are touching our sternum, the center of our chest, as we continue to ground our mind and our bodies here today. Taking a moment to check in with self, seeing how we feel right here, right now, in our present moment, without judgment, simply taking notice. As we allow our palms to flow to the earth, connecting our hands to our yoga mat, using our palms to connect with our environment. Taking a moment to notice what is going on around us without judgment. Two more breaths. As we breathe our palms above our heads, coming into a seated salute, fingertips flows up towards the heavens, interlacing the fingers with the pointer finger pointing up towards the heavens. Allowing the arms to flow slightly towards the back of the room. Chin is up, heart chakras open. Three breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling back to center, separating our palms, coming into our seated extended mountain, meaning our palms are separated. When our palms are together, we are in that seated salute. Palms are separated, seated extended mountain. As we are channeling in hope and positivity. Opening up their heart chakra, chin is up. Two more breaths. As we twist the body towards the right, palms come downward towards the earth, slightly gazing over that right shoulder. Relaxing and soothing our spine. If we choose, we can take this left hand connected to our right knee and go deeper into that spinal twist. Soothing and decompressing the spine. Three breaths. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to center, coming into a seated star. In our star, our palms are slightly outward towards the side. Heart chakras open, chin is up. Breathe in. Exhale, twist the body towards the left, palms come downward towards the earth as we gaze over that left shoulder, feeling that spinal twist, decompressing our spine. We can connect this right hand to our left knee if that feels good, going deeper into that twist. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling back to center, coming into that seated star, coming into that extended mountain, palms above the head, coming into that salute, breathing our palms together, interlacing our fingers as we lean our bodies towards the right, coming into that crescent moon, feeling this stretch in your side body here, slightly gazing up at the heavens if that feels good. Back's elongated, tummies are tight. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhale back to center as we lean our bodies towards the left, feeling this side bend, opposite side. Crescent moon, slightly gazing up at the heavens. Three breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling back to center. Breathing our palms down, their heart center, coming into that seated prayer. Relaxing those shoulders downward away from the ears. Gaze in the eyes downward or close in the eyes. Breathe in. Exhale. As we flow our feet into a down position, coming into a diamond or a butterfly. In a diamond, our feet are further away from our bodies. In a butterfly, our feet are closer towards the body. That is the difference between the two. This is a hip opener. Listening to your body and noticing how this feels within your hip flexors here. As we slightly hinge at the hips, if we're able, when we hinge at the hips, we come deeper into that hip opener. So only going down as much as your body comfortably allows you to go down. As our shoulders melt forward and our head melts downward towards our feet. We're going to hold this for four breaths. Two more breaths. Exhaling back up to our diamond or our butterfly, using our hands to bring our knees in, straightening our legs, coming towards staff pose. Our legs are parallel, straight in front of us. Toes are pointing up towards the heavens. Spinal cords are nice and elongated. Tummies are tucked at our navel. Shoulders relax downward away from the ears. As we are gazing forward, closing the eyes or gazing downward. Breathe in. Exhale. Here in our staff pose, may we go inwards, focusing on self for three breaths. Two breaths. As we flow our palms above our heads and our snoot, breathing our palms together. Exhaling down to prayer, palms come heart center. As we slightly hinge at the hips, we are in that seated half forward fold. You may feel this behind your legs and your hamstrings. So now we are working on loosening the hamstrings and the back of the knee. And if we want to come deeper in this stretch, we can bring our hands to our ankles or our hands to our feet, coming into a complete forward fold, allowing the shoulders to melt forward, head melts downward towards the knees. And we're going to hang out here for three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling up to half, coming back up to our staff pose, relaxing and soothing the body as we breathe that right leg in the air, right knee is in the air, right foot is flat on the earth. We're going to work on our Sage Marichi. We're going to cross this right foot over this left leg. We're going to take this right hand, bring it behind our backs with our fingertips facing away from us. We're going to bring this left elbow over that right knee. As we gaze over our right shoulder. And you may feel your spinal cord twisting and soothing and decompressing as we take nice, subtle breaths. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to center, uncrossing that foot, coming back into that staff pose. Hinging at the hips, coming to a half forward fold or a complete forward fold. If that feels good, three breaths. Two breaths. And exhaling back up to our staff as we take this left leg up in the air, knees in the air, left foot is flat on the earth. We're going to cross this left foot over that right leg. Take this left hand behind our backs with our fingertips facing away from us. Crossing this right elbow over that left knee as we gaze over our left shoulder. Feeling this spinal twist decompressing here. Gazing the eyes down or closing them. Three breaths. Two more breaths. Exhaling back forward, uncrossing that leg, coming back into that staff pose as we breathe our palms above our heads and our salute. Chin is up. Breathe in deeply. Exhale a prayer. Relaxing those palms at heart center. We're going to flow onto our backs, coming into a reclined position, hugging our knees into our chest. Allowing those shoulders to relax back into the yoga mat. As we straighten our legs up in the air, legs on a wall pose, pointing those toes upwards towards the heavens. As we reach down to the lower parts of our legs, we're going to breathe our legs towards our torso. Legs, the torso stretch, buttocks come slightly off the earth. Two breaths. Exhale back up to legs on a wall. Breathing our knees into our chest. Coming into a happy baby. Feet is up in the air. Hands come between the thighs. Out towards the edges, connecting our hands to our feet. This is also a hip opener. We are using a happy baby to soothe and relax our inner thighs. Opening up our hips. As the yoga mat is relaxing and soothing our spinal cord. Gazing the eyes down or closing the eyes. Three more breaths. Two breaths. We're going to find our pause here now, happy baby. And we're going to rock our body from side to side. Using the earth to relax and massage our spine. Four breaths. Two breaths. Finding our pause at center. Extending our legs straight up in the air. Reaching down to the lower parts of our legs and breathing our legs towards our torso. Feeling that legs to body stretch. Exhale back up to legs on the wall. Breathing our knees into our chest. Extending our legs straight out in front of us, like we're coming into a shavasana, but we are not. We're going to work on a fish pose. We're going to use our shoulders to lift our chest up, or use our elbows, shall I say, to lift our chest up. We're going to come on the tops of our heads. We are in that fish. We are in that fish pose. Shoulders melt back to the yoga mat. You'll feel that arch in your spinal cord. Your chest is up. We can breathe our palms at heart center if that feels good. Breathing our palms at heart center if that feels good. We also can take our feet off the earth, coming into a flying fish. When we come into a flying fish, taking our feet off the earth, you'll notice that you'll feel it here in your core, your obliques, your abdominal muscles. Or we can just keep our feet down on the earth and be in our fish pose. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling out of that flying fish or fish pose, hugging the knees into the chest, allowing the knees to flow towards the left, reclined spinal twist. Yes, we are soothing and relaxing our spinal cord here today. Feeling that spine decompress as our right arm comes out to the side like a T. We can gaze up at the heavens or gaze over that right shoulder. Allowing the shoulder blades to melt back into the yoga mat. Three breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling back to center, hugging knees into chest. Allowing the knees to flow towards the right. Recline spinal twist, opposite side, feeling that spinal cord soothe. Gazing up at the heavens or gazing over that left shoulder, bringing that left arm out to the side like a T, gazing over that shoulder. We're gonna relax here for three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhale back to center, hugging the knees into the chest. Bringing our feet parallel, side by side. We're gonna flow up into a boat pose. Doing an abdominal crunch, lifting that body up, working that core. We are in that boat pose. The boat pose works the abdominals, it also works the obliques. Keeping that back nice and elongated here. Chin is up. Tummies are nice and tight. Four breaths. Two breaths. Holding on to this bow pose, we're going to pound our hands from side to side. Going a little bit deeper here into our obliques. Six breaths. Four breaths. Two breaths. Finding our pause at center, bringing our knees into our chest, bringing our feet to our hands. We are using our tailbone to keep our bodies up here. Spinal cords are nice and long. Heart chakras open, chin is up. We're going to work on a boat pose variation, extending that left leg out towards the side. So that left leg comes out and you'll feel that stretch here behind your legs and your hamstrings. As we are gaze forward with that chin up. Breathe in deeply. Exhale. Two more breaths. Breathing that left foot back in as we extend that right leg out towards the side. Feeling that stretch. You'll feel this behind your legs here, your hamstrings. Heart chakras open, chin is up. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling that feet back in. We're gonna extend that left leg back out. We're gonna extend that right leg out. Our legs look like a V. Now we can bend our knees if that feels better for us, or we can straighten the legs. We are in a nice wide-legged V, allowing that V to become nice and wide if we choose. Or we can bring the feet closer together, closing off that V. When we close off the V, you'll feel that you're working your abdominals a little more. You'll feel that you are balancing the body a little more. When we come into that wide-legged V, you'll feel that you are stretching the inner thighs a little more. So whatever feels best for you. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhale, bringing the feet in. Come into a diamond or a butterfly. Slightly hinging at the hips, coming into that half forward fold. Torso melts downward towards the legs, shoulders melt forward, head comes down towards the feet. Gaze in the eyes, down the close of the eye. As we breathe in, exhale. Three more breaths. Exhaling up to center, using our hands to bring our knees in, crossing our feet at our ankles as we come into a tabletop pose. We are on our hands and our knees. Palms are flat on the earth. As we drop down to our cow, tummies come downward towards the earth. You'll feel this curvature in your lumbar spine. Chin is up. And you'll feel this in your lower back. This is great for low back pain. We're going to hold this 3 breaths. 2 breaths. Flow into our cat, breathing our chin to our clavicle. Spinal cord flows up towards the heavens, tucking our tummy in at our navel. Cat pose. Flow into cow. Exhale to cat. Come into our table. As we breathe our right leg towards the back, feeling that stretch. Both palms are flat on the earth. As we pulse that right leg up in the air, we are working at gluteus maximus. Lifting and rounding that buttocks. 4 breaths. 2 breaths. We're going to find that pause, extending that left arm forward. So we have the right leg towards the back, left arm forward. We are nailing that full sunbird. This sunbird relaxes. It actually balances and strengthens the body here. As we are gazed forward, 3 breaths. 2 breaths. Breathe in deeply. Exhale, knee to elbow, feeling that crunch, bringing that knee to that elbow. Back to three-legged. Knee to elbow. Back to three-legged. Knee to elbow. My apologies, back to sunbird. Coming back to our table, dropping down to cow. Exhaling to cat. Lowering back to our table as we extend that left leg towards the back. We are working the opposite side here, feeling that stretch. Both palms are flat on the earth as we pulse that left leg up and down. We are rounding and lifting that gluteus maximus. 3 more breaths. 2 breaths. We're going to find that pause, extending that right arm forward, full sunbird, opposite side, gaze forward, balancing and lengthening here. 3 more breaths. 2 breaths. Taking a nice deep breath in. Exhale, knee to elbow, feeling that crunch. Back to sunbird. Knee to elbow. Back to bird. Knee to elbow, feeling that crunch. Back to bird, 2 breaths. Exhale into our table as we drop down to cow. Exhale to cat. Coming back to our table. As we breathe our right arm up in the air, fingertips flows towards the heavens, gazing up at those fingertips. Breathe in. Exhale, thread the needle, right arm threads through the left heart chakra, comes downward towards the earth. We are relaxing on the sides of our right ear. Taking a nice deep breath in. Exhale, allowing the shoulder blades to melt forward, gazing the eyes downward or closing the eyes. 4 breaths. Optioning to wrap that arm behind your back or extending it above your head, palms flat on the earth, whatever you choose. 2 more breaths. slowly unwrapping that arm if it was wrapped. We're going to come back into our tabletop, dropping down to cow. Exhale to cat. Flow into our table as we breathe that left arm up in the air. Fingertips flows towards the heavens, gazing up at those fingertips, feeling that stretch. Breathe in. Exhale, left arm flows through the left, thread the needle, opposite side, bringing that torso downward towards the yoga mat. The left side of the ear or the head is connected to the earth. Shoulder blades are melted forward, eyes are gazed downward or closed. Feeling the body soothed. And we can option to wrap this right arm behind our backs. Or we can breathe it above our heads, palms flat on the earth. Whatever feels good for you. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Slowly unwrapping that arm, we're going to unthread that needle, coming back to our table as we push our bodies up to our down dog, gazing at our feet. Tummies are tight as we are walking our dog by pedaling our feet left and right. We're going to find our paws, shifting our weight forward, coming into a high plank. Dropping down to a chaturanga or a low plank, hovering over the yoga mat, building strength. Exhaling onto our tummies, coming into a Sphinx pose. We are on our tummies. We are on our forearms. Shoulders are relaxed away from the ears, meaning we are not sulking. Having control of the body, chin is up. Gazing the eyes down. This Sphinx pose is a slight back bend. As we take a nice, deep, intentional breath in. Exhale through the mouth. And we're going to relax here in our Sphinx pose, simply going inward in silent meditation for four natural breaths. Keeping the chin up. With the eyes gaze down or closed. Three more breaths. Exhaling down to our Superman, Supergirl, extending our arms in front of us. Legs comes off the earth. And our Superman and Supergirl, we are working our arms. We are working our the backs of our legs, our gluteus maximus, as well as our backs here. As we are gaze forward, optioning to fly from side to side if we choose, or we can simply stay still. Three more breaths. Two breaths. We're going to swim our hands towards the back, coming into a locust pose. The locust pose also works the arms, the back, the gluteus maximus. We are framing the backs of our bodies here. Toning and firming. Chin is up. Heart chakra is open. Three more breaths. Locust pose. Two breaths. Here in our locust pose, we're going to find our paws. Staying in locust, we're going to come into a sleeping locust, allowing our shoulders to melt forward. Allowing our forehead, our third eye chakra, to connect to the yoga mat. Taking a nice breath in. Exhale. Feeling your body melt forward. Here in our sleeping locus, our third eye chakra, our forehead is connected to the yoga mat. As we are using this time to go in. Using this time to see what is needed, what is wanted. In our lives, just taking a moment to go inward, noticing and being aware without judgment, always being kind and loving to oneself. May we relax here and sleep in locus 5 natural breaths. Three more breaths. Slowly exhaling out of that sleeping locus, coming back to that locus pose, lifting the legs and the arms off the earth. Torso comes off the earth. You'll feel that slight back bend here. Chin is up. And we're going to flow into a bow pose or a half bow, connecting our right hand to our right ankle, half bow, connecting our left hand to our left ankle, full bow pose. This here is a deeper back bend, using our hands connecting to our feet to lift our torsos further away from the earth, coming into that bow pose. Our heart chakra is open, our chin is up. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling out of that bow pose, swimming those arms forward, coming back into that Sphinx pose. We are back on our forearms, shoulders are relaxed away from the ears, remembering to not shrug, having control of that body here. Chin is up, gaze in the eyes down, taking a nice breath in, exhale. As we flow into a baby cobra, bringing our palms next to our torso, our elbows are slightly bent, pushing our torso away from the yoga mat just a little. That is that baby cobra. Chin is up. Exhale into the cobra, straightening those elbows a little more. Now we are in that cobra pose. Shoulders are relaxed away from the ears. Chin is up. Heart chakra is open. Flow into our up dog, untucking our toes, lifting our thighs off the earth. We are now in that up dog. Exhale into down dog, gazing at the feet. Pushing our thighs, pushing our torso towards our thighs, feeling that nice deep stretch. As we walk our dog by pedaling our feet left and right. We're going to find pause as we breathe our right foot to our right hand, runner's lunge. We're going to drop that left knee down to the earth, low lunge. Lifting our torso away from our thigh, breathing our arms up in the air, crescent lunge. Heart chakras open, chin is up. Feeling a stretch here in the inner thighs. Two more breaths. Exhale, framing that front foot, taking that left knee off the earth, back in that runner's lunge. Exhale to pyramid, straightening that front leg. Torso relaxes over that thigh, head comes down towards that knee. Feeling that nice stretch. Exhale back to runner's lunge. Breathe down dog, gazing at the feet. Walking our dog, pedaling our feet left and right. As we breathe that left foot to left hand, runner's lunge, opposite side. Dropping that right knee down, coming into that low lunge. Lifting that torso away from that thigh, breathing those arms up in the air, crescent lunge. Heart chakras open, chin is up. Exhale, forward frame in that front foot. Taking that right knee off the earth, back into that runner's lunge. Straightening that front leg, coming into that pyramid. Head relaxes downward over that knee. Feeling that stretch behind your legs. Two more breaths. Exhale back forward, one is lunge. Breathe down dog, gazing at the feet. As we walk our feet towards our hands, coming into that complete forward fold. Feeling that body relax and soothe. This forward fold is a full body stretch. We're gonna hang out here, three more breaths. Exhale up to half forward fold. Backs are straight, slightly gaze forward. Two more breaths. Yogi walking our feet slightly apart, creating that nice stance. We're gonna come back down to a complete forward fold, allowing that head to melt down. Connecting the hands to the ankles. Or we can flow into a ragdoll, connecting the hands to the elbows, allowing that head to relax down. Feeling this full body stretch, we can option to rock or sway our bodies from side to side in our ragdoll. Noticing that when we rock and sway, you'll feel it behind your legs and your hamstrings here. Four more breaths. Two breaths. Finding pause at center, coming into that half forward fold. Breathing up to our Tadasana, our mountain pose. Palms are at our side. Heart chakras open, chin is up. Feet are planted into the yoga mat. Feeling grounded, feeling rooted. As we breathe our palms above our heads, standing salute, palms are together, interlacing the fingers, pointer finger points up towards the heavens. As we allow our arms to flow towards the back, feeling this light back then here. Exhaling back up to center, separating those palms, coming into that standing extended mountain. As our bodies lean towards the right, coming into that standing side bend, slightly gazing up at the heavens. Three breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling back to center, leaning the body towards the left, side bend opposite side. Gazing up at the heavens, if that feels good, opening up that heart chakra. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to center, coming into that standing salute, palms together. Exhale down to prayer, bringing the palms at heart center. Relaxing those shoulders downward, away from the ears. Here in our standing prayer, may we gaze our eyes downward or close our eyes. Taking a moment to just check in with self, seeing how we feel in our present moment. Three breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling, hanging back the hips, coming into that half forward fold.
Sorry, I'm not sure about that.
Two more breaths, half forward fold, two more breaths. Exhaling down to a complete forward fold, feeling it, full body stretch as the head melts down. Three breaths. Exhaling, half forward fold. Yogi walking our feet slightly apart, just a little. Breathing our palms at heart center. We're going to bend our knees, coming into a chair pose. working the lower parts of our bodies here in our chair. We can extend our arms in front of us if that feels good. Chin is up. Exhaling back to prayer hands as we twist our bodies towards the right. Chair pose twist. Rebreaths. Exhale into center. Chair pose twist opposite side. Three breaths. Exhale back to center. Breathe half forward fold, straightening those knees. Coming into a complete forward fold. Walking the hands forward, bringing our feet towards the back, down dog. Pedaling our dog, walking our dog by pedaling our feet left and right. We're gonna find our pause, breathing our right foot to our right hand, runner's lunge. Exhaling up to warrior two, working the lower parts of our bodies. Feeling the movements here, feeling the body strengthen and toned in that warrior two. Two more breaths. Exhale and reverse warrior, feeling that slight back bend. Exhale into side angle, crossing that right arm over that right thigh. Extended side angle, breathing that left arm up in the air or over the head, feeling that stretch. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to warrior two. Breathe forward to warrior one. Twisting that body forward. Both arms are up in the air. Chin is up. Exhale back to warrior two. Twisting a body forward. Half forward fold. Wide legged. Half forward fold. Allowing that head to melt down to complete forward fold. Walking the hands forward, bringing the feet together, back and down dog. As we pedal our feet, walking our dog. Finding pause, breathing that left foot to left hand. Runner's lunge opposite side. Exhaling up to warrior two. Working the lower parts of our bodies. Feeling the body's tone and firm here. As we float to reverse warrior, feeling that slight back bend. Chin is up. Exhaling to side angle, crossing that left arm over that left thigh. Or extended side angle, breathing that right leg, that right arm up in the air or over the head. Two more breaths. Exhale back to warrior two. Breathing to warrior one. Twisting the body forward. Both arms are up in the air. Chin is up. Heart chakras open. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to warrior two, feeling the movement. Twisting the body forward, exhale, half forward fold. We are wide legged. Breathing to a complete forward fold, allowing that head to relax down. Exhale into half forward fold. Bringing our feet, twisting our feet to the outer parts of the yoga mat. Coming up slightly straight. We're going to bend our knees, coming into pack of hands. Goddess, God stance. We are continuing to work the lower parts of our bodies here. We are toning. We are firming. We can pause the body up and down here in our goddess, God stance.
noticing the muscles we are working as we are pausing. Or we can rock that body from side to side, working more muscles here, feeling a burn, or we can simply stay still. Two more breaths. Exhaling up to our standing star, bringing our arms out towards the side. Legs are wide-legged, heart chakras open, chin is up. Feeling nice and strong and powerful, feeling bright like the star, shining brightly regardless. Knowing who we are, knowing where we're going, knowing what we want. And as we continue to grow and flow in our lives, may we always be grounded. May we always be rooted. Two more breaths. Exhaling back down to that goddess stance, that God stance. Flowing the arms above the head, coming into that goddess salute. Chin is up. Exhale down to prayer, palms come at heart center. Coming back to cactus hands. Exhale, complete forward fold, wide legged, head nuts down towards the feet. Taking a nice deep breath in. Exhale. This wide legged forward fold is a counter stretch to what we just did. Using this wide legged to soothe and relax the muscles. Gazing the eyes downward, closing the eyes. Four more breaths. Walking the hands forward, bringing the feet together, down dog. Coming onto our forearms, coming into a dolphin pose. Buttocks is in the air as we are gazed to the back of the room. Dolphin pose. Optioning to pulse up and down on our tippy toes if that feels good. Dropping down to our knees, coming into a wide-legged child's pose or puppy pose. Bringing the torso downward towards the yoga mat. Third eye chakra connects to the yoga mat. Allowing the shoulders to melt forward. Allowing the body and the mind to relax and soothe. Tuning out anything around us that isn't serving and soothing for us in our practice here today. Allowing the eyes to gaze down or closing them if that feels good for you. Here in our child's pose or puppy pose, may we use this time to let out anything that isn't serving. May we use this time to completely think of self. We're going to relax here in silent meditation for 6 natural breaths. Flowing hands into prayer hands if that feels good for you. 3 more breaths. Extending our arms in front of us with the palms flat on the earth. Spinal waving our bodies out of our child's pose or puppy pose. Using our palms to push reach out towards those four and using our palms to push our buttocks towards our heels. Final wave in that body. We can allow our head and our neck to also flow. Rotating and moving the entire spinal cord. Feeling that body smooth. Feeling that spinal cord decompress. Two more breaths. Finding our pause at center, coming to our table, dropping down to cow. Exhale to cat. Lower back to our table as we cross our feet at our ankles, coming onto our buttocks just for a second. We're going to come into a reclined position, hugging our knees into our chest. Extending our legs up in the air, legs on the wall poles, pointing our toes towards the heavens. Reaching down, connecting our hands to the lower parts of our feet as we breathe our feet towards our torso. Exhale the legs back up to legs on the wall, holding the legs up in the air. Now I want to show the legs to melt towards the back. Flowing into the yoga mat. Eyes are gazed down and closed. Optioning to go up towards the wall and allowing your feet to literally be on the wall if that feels good for you. For those who are not going up towards the wall and the feet is not on the wall, we're going to breathe our knees into our chest, holding our knees there. As we bring our feet flat downward towards the earth. So feet is on the earth, knees are up in the air. We're gonna allow our legs, our knees to flow towards the left. Window wiping. Allowing our knees to flow towards the right. Just like we are window wiping blades on a car. Just feeling the knees flow to the right and flow to the left. And you'll feel this here in your lumbar spine. We are working and soothing that spine. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to center. Keeping our feet flat on the earth. Keeping our knees up in the air. We're going to use our feet and our palms. Our palms is next to our buttocks, flat on the earth. To push our torso up. We're working on that bridge pose. Lifting that torso up, that gluteus maximus crunches up, squeezes up, lifting and rounding that buttocks here. We can take our hands underneath our buttocks if that feels good and walk our shoulder blades towards our spine and our chest. Heart chakra comes higher in the air. Now we are in that deep bridge as we lift that gluteus maximus up nice and high. Feeling that buttocks round and lift. We can pause the gluteus maximus up and down if that feels good. Or we can simply stay still. We also can flow into a three-legged bridge, bringing that left foot to that right knee and right foot to left knee. Rotating between the two. Whichever feels good for you, we're going to hang out here in our bridge, freestyling for 6 natural breaths. Four breaths. Two breaths. We're going to pause that gluteus maximus up nice and high and squeeze it nice and tightly. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Feeling the burn, rounding and lifting here. 2 more breaths, bonus points. Exhale down, untuck your nose, shoulders, breathing the knees into the chest, hugging the knees into the chest. As our knees flow towards the left, recline, final twist. Feeling that spine decompressed. Right arm comes out to the side like a T. Gazing up at the heavens or gazing over that arm. Four breaths. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to center. Knees flows towards the right. Recline, spinal twist, opposite side. Left arm comes out to the side like a T. Gazing up at the heavens or gazing over that left arm. Four breaths. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to center, straightening out the legs, coming into a Shavasana, rest pose. Legs are parallel side by side. The sides of our feet are connecting. They are touching as we allow our feet to fall to the sides like a V, completely relaxing our legs as our shoulder blades flows to the back of the yoga mat, connecting to the earth. Gaze in the eyes down or close in the eyes. Shavasana. Rest pose, 5 breaths. Two more breaths. As we roll onto our side, coming into a fetal pose. Keeping our eyes gazed down or closed if that feels good. 3 breaths. Using our top hand to push our bodies up, coming into a seated pose. Any seated pose that feels good for you, I'm going to come into a cow face. May you find your seat that feels good, or you can option to stay in a rest pose or fetal pose. If we are in our seated position, ensuring that our spinal cord is elongated, tummies are tucked at our navel. Shoulders are relaxed downward away from the ears. Maybe our eyes are gazed downward or closed. Our chin is relaxed. Our facial muscles are relaxed. Our forehead is relaxed. As we breathe our palms at heart center, coming into that seated prayer. Using this time to thank ourselves for allowing ourselves to practice self-care here today. For in a busy world, it is a beautiful thing when we find time for self. And I would like to thank you so much for allowing me to practice self-care with you here today, for it truly, truly is a blessing. The light in me sees, appreciates, and respects the light in you all. Namaste.